I'm Eric Backer, the naturopath from New Zealand. Thanks for tuning into my video again. I always appreciate viewers. If you're not a subscriber, it's cool if you could be, because I like people, more and more people watching these videos, because it's great, because I try and make these for lots of people to look at and get free information from. So hopefully you're going to benefit from this too. So let's talk about allicin and alanine. Sounds like a pair of sisters, don't they? Like two girls or something. So allicin is quite an interesting compound that you'll find in garlic. In fact, it's what gives our garlic that pungent smell, that very strong smell. So there's an enzyme in garlic called alliinase. When you chop garlic up, it converts a compound called alanine into allicin. Okay, it's almost like someone coming out and saying that they're different all of a sudden. But the allicin is a very powerful compound. It's been known only really since the 40s. It's interesting. I was just reading online that it was discovered only in 1944, which isn't that long ago, and it was discovered when they were trying to make a vitamin B1 supplement, and they discovered this compound. So there's no doubt about it. Allicin is one of the most impressive compounds, sulfur-containing compounds that have a very powerful effect on bacteria. But not just that. Okay, there are various enzymes in the body that are revved up with allicin, and it certainly has very beneficial effects on many aspects of the immune function. Many studies have shown that eating, garlic daily will certainly help to reduce the incidence of colds and flus. So it's good information if you want to keep your immune system in top shape, is to eat more of these compounds. I've always been a big promoter of garlic, red onions, brown onions, shallots, scallions, spring onions, all of that whole family, leeks. These are really good, healthy foods to eat. Okay, fantastic for liver cleansing and for keeping the bacteria in the tummy in good shape. But is allicin enough? Do you need any more for SIBO? Well, you do. Allicin is a good product, but many naturopaths I find will use the Allimax, which is a powerful allicin product on its own. I used to do that. I used to use Allimax quite a lot in the clinic until I found it just wasn't enough. Okay, you need berberine, you need neem, you need extra things in there to tackle bacteria. Okay, particularly a wide range of bacterial disturbances in the gut are not going to respond just to allicin on its own. Even if you look at some of the best blogs or sites regarding SIBO, you'll see that they usually recommend a berberine containing herb, allicin, they'll recommend neem, they could recommend other things there as well. And that's exactly why I made CanXida Remove. Because guess what? It contains a very powerful allicin extract in it, okay? In combination, of course, with berberine and neem and other antimicrobials. So this is what you get when you put a compound product together from quality ingredients. You get super powerful outcomes from patients, and that's what we're consistently getting now, from many countries now where people are using Remove. We're getting good feedback. Yes, Allimax is a great product, but the unfortunate thing is you need to buy that, then you'll need to buy berberine, and you'll need to buy this and that, and before you know it, you've spent hundreds of dollars on multiple products, and there's no need to do that. A good compound product will generally do the job. That's all I wanted to say. Thanks for tuning in.